Networking is an important route for finding and obtaining positions. Through these personal contacts, you get much more tailored information directly from people who've made the transition into different types of careers. To find people to talk to for more in-depth career discussions, a good place to start can be professional networking sites such as LinkedIn. There you can search for people who have similar skill sets or backgrounds as you, and you can simply approach them and ask if they'd be willing to talk to you about their career. You also might be a member of different networks, such as an alumni association or a scientific society, where you can find people to talk to about their careers. An informational interview is an informal discussion about careers where you can get advice and information. What's important here is not to take it as an interview that will lead to a job, but really as a source of inspiration and advice. One way to structure these interviews is to use REVEAL, which stands for Recap, Explore, Vision, Entry Routes, Action Points, and Links. Recap is basically you start by recapping who you are and why you'd like to talk to this person. You then use the list of questions you came up with to explore the career area and the role and sector. You then can follow this up with more detailed questions about the vision. What are the trends for this field in the future? And what might your career look like in the longer term if you were to take a position in one of these roles? After this, you can ask about the entry routes, so how the person you're talking to got to the role, and if this is a typical path or there are different ways of getting in. This is closely linked then to the next point, action points. So what would you need to do to get these kinds of roles? This can also be a good point to ask for feedback on your CV. Finally, links. So there might be other resources that the person can recommend that will be helpful for you, and you can ask for those at the end of the interview. One thing scientists often struggle with is working out what kinds of jobs they're best suited to. One way to start is to really think in depth about your skills, values, and interests. You can use this information then to filter the information that you're reading and hearing and work out which is the right path for you. So you can, for example, look for people with this skill set on LinkedIn and see what kinds of roles they have and gain some inspiration for what you might be interested in. There are a whole variety of options out there for people that don't want to stay on the academic career path. Obviously, there's research in pharma, biotechs, and startups, but there's also a variety of roles where you'd be using your scientific knowledge, understanding of the research process, or data analysis skills. These roles often support scientific research, help communicate research findings more broadly, or help translate research into real-life applications.